QB. What y'all like?
You've said, though, that if you did run for president, you believe you'd win.
Well, I don't know. I think I'd win. I tell you what, I wouldn't go in to lose. I've never gone into losing in my life.
Distinguished gentleman, puts a castle on his back, made back a exotic lady, eye catcher, holla at ya. Call me the chiropractor, working like Muay Thai class, get pressed fire out ya. And of course, I've been the boss's back when rocking D-Boy, Fila Valor in a 190 black Benz. Now they shut down the stores that I'm shopping. Used to be train robbing, face covered in stock, and I'm now. Ain't gleaming, switch your lanes, two seat and hate him, a lover for the same reason. Can't leave it, the game needs him, plus the people need someone to believe in. Come at me, I'ma rip your soldiers in half. Silverback ape, nickel-plated mag. Young, rich, and flashy, young. I'm nasty, all black clothes. The ice lay on me so classy. And every time I close my lids, I can still see the barrel, I can still see the bridge, can still see the dreams that my they never lived to see. Tell them angels open the door for me. From nine Berettas and moving raw, to chilling in wine cellar sticks and humidors. That's what I call mature, that's what I call a G, that's what I call a pimp, that's what I call a gangster to the fullest. I'm trying to make more cream by every September 14th. That's my dream, so I can be more clean. As I grow yearly, I can see things more clearly. That's why they fear me. Chain gleamers, switch your lanes, two seat and hate them, but love them for the same reason. Can't leave it, the game needs them. Plus the people need someone to believe in. So in God's son we trust, cause they know I'ma give them what they want. They're looking for a
said a negative thing about a white supremacist. Have you heard him say anything? I haven't.
Racism is evil, and those who cause violence in its name are criminals and thugs, including the KKK, neo-Nazis, white supremacists, and other hate groups that are repugnant to everything we hold dear as Americans.
I totally disavow the Ku Klux Klan. I totally disavow David Duke.
The neo-Nazis and the white nationalists, because they should be condemned totally.
In one voice, our nation must condemn racism, bigotry, and white supremacy.
Recalling his early Senate career, bringing up two segregationist senators, Herman Talmadge and James Eastland, who called African Americans an inferior race.
We already have a nigger mayor. We don't need any more nigger big shots.
You have a problem figuring out whether you're for me or Trump, and you ain't black.
What's something that you always carry with you?
Hot sauce.
Now, listen, yes. I just want you to know, people are going to see this and say, okay, she's pandering to black people.
Is it working?
Yeah. African-American communities have suffered under Democratic control. To those I say the following. What do you have to lose by trying something new like Trump? What do you have to lose?
Come up here. Come here. She looks so smart. Do you mind if I do a job interview right now? We need good people. How are you? So what's your experience in front of the world?
Well, I design, I do recycling.
If we can make a good deal in the salary, she's going to probably have a job.
Okay.
Kiss her. Thank you. So nice.
Another chapter, the cleanest rapper, distinguished gentleman, cooks a castle on his back, made back a exotic lady, eye catcher, holla at ya, call me the chiropractor, working like Muay Thai class, can press fire out ya, and of course I've been the boss's...
Provide a little relief as we are covering all this serious news. You see a Marine alongside Marine One lost his cap. The president goes to help put it back in. It falls off again. As he pats him on the side, he goes and he grabs it again. So
Trump, man, y'all is crazy.
After that, me and Donald Trump hung out.
Humpty Hump, because he making more than Donald Trump.
Beef is going off like Donald Trump gets checked.
The brothers call me Black Trump.
be paid like Donald Trump.
I'm talking Trump tight access. They coming off a gang of
Trump. I'm talking Donald Trump.
The new Don Trump is Bill Gates. Not because his occupation, it's cause we respect his cake.
Bill Gates, Donald Trump, let me hear now.
If I bring your ass over the hump, we're trying to get money so we can be living like Trump.
We can talk Trump, talk real estate, stocks, and bonds.
I buy cars with straight cash, have meetings with Donald Trump.
Pull up my state like Donald Trump.
27 cars and a 12-bedroom house. Now they call me Snoopy Troy.
Yeah, Donald Trump, them are fire, yo.
Spend absurd money, private bird money. That Bill Gates, Donald Trump, Bloomberg money.
Boys in the hood call me Black Donald Trump.
Direction of the real time to get richer than Trump.
I still does it, breathing off a Trump budget. Fire, motherfucker, Donald Trump.
Give me fame and fortune, me and Trump on golf courses. First of the month. Trump to the buyers, red toupee on the coupe, you been fired.
Over the world when I'm on my Donald Trump shit. Look at all this money, ain't that some shit?
Tryna get it till I'm on my Donald Trump. Looking rapper, I ain't trying to stunt. I'ma fire my blunt like Donald Trump.
About to look at sales, Donald Trump fix me.
Donald Trump. I made four lists this month.
Made a million on that comic going Donald Trump.
Donald Trump, Bill Gates, or Bruce Wayne.
Don't sell your money like I'm Donald Trump. Up like Donald Trump. Up, say swing like I'm Trump.
I'm fucked worse than Donald Trump. On Lexapro in Mexico. Across from a Texaco at McDonald's drunk.
G-Unit Radio. G-Unit Radio. Who cares?
I'm here with Donald Trump. I never thought I'd be next to this guy, man. Mr. Trump, are you going to buy my album June 28th? Go to the Predator Fest.
You're going to buy all your albums? Line.
Can you buy 10 million albums?
I can buy whatever you throw at me. Whoa. And I'll be first in line to buy your album.
Thank you, sir. Wow, that's I just want to be your friend.
I don't think they believe he's hit.
Mr. Donald Trump.
This is one shot, one kill. What's the deal? See, who I'm sitting next to? Donald Trump. Smell the money. Nigga, you know you. Where? It's Tony Ayo up in this. Donald Trump, just say something.
I'm here, folks.
Oh, y'all like?
Smell the money.
Great
people. Smell the money.
We are a generous and welcoming people here in the United States, but those who enter the country illegally and those who employ them disrespect the rule of law, and they are showing disregard for those who are following the law. We simply cannot allow people to pour into the United States undetected, undocumented, unchecked, and circumventing the line of people who are waiting patiently, diligently, and lawfully to become immigrants.
All Americans, not only in the states most heavily affected, but in every place in this country, are rightly disturbed by the large numbers of illegal aliens entering our country. The jobs they hold might otherwise be held by citizens or legal immigrants. The public service they use impose burdens on our taxpayers. That's why our administration has moved aggressively to secure our borders more by hiring a record number of new border guards, by deporting twice as many criminal aliens as ever before, by cracking down on illegal hiring, by barring welfare benefits to illegal aliens. In the budget I will present to you, we will try to do more to speed the deportation of illegal aliens who are arrested for crimes, to better identify illegal aliens in the workplace, as recommended by the commission headed by former Congresswoman Barbara Jordan. We are a nation of immigrants, but we are also a nation of laws.
Even as we are a nation of immigrants, we're also a nation of laws. Undocumented workers broke our immigration laws, and I believe that they must be held accountable, especially those who may be dangerous. When I took office, I committed to fixing this broken immigration system, and I began by doing what I could to secure our borders. But today, our immigration system is broken, and everybody knows it. There are actions I have the legal authority to take as president. Tonight, I'm announcing those actions. We'll build on our progress at the border with additional resources for our law enforcement personnel so that they can stem the flow of illegal crossings and speed the return of those who do cross over. If you're a criminal, you'll be deported. If you plan to enter the U.S. illegally, your chances of getting caught and sent back just went up. We expect people who live in this country to play by the rules. We expect that those who cut the line will not be unfairly rewarded. The actions I'm taking are not only lawful, they're the kinds of actions taken by every single Republican president and every single Democratic president for the past half century. And to those members of Congress who question my authority to make our immigration system work better, or question the wisdom of me acting where Congress has failed, I have one answer. Pass a bill.
Oh yeah, what'd they say? I was running for president. No, I voted. No, what'd they say? I switched. If you don't read the newspaper, you're uninformed. If you do read it, you're misinformed.
So what do you do?
That's a great question. What is the long-term effect of too much information? One of the effects is the need to be first, not even to be true anymore. So what a responsibility you all have to tell the truth, not just to be first. But to tell the truth, we live in a society now where it's just first. Who cares? Get it out there. We don't care who it hurts. We don't care who we destroy. We don't care if it's true. Just say it. Sell it. Anything you practice, you'll get good at. Including BS.
And then we call it the wrap-up smear. If you want to talk politics, you call it the wrap-up smear. You smear somebody with falsehoods and all the rest, and then you merchandise it. And then you write it, and they'll say, see, it's reported in the press that this, 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 and this. So they have that validation that the press reported the smear, and then it's called the wrap-up smear. Now I'm going to merchandise the press's report on the smear that we made. And it's a tactic.
So did you catch that? What she says is you start out with something that's a lie, and you throw it out there, and then the press picks up on it, and they write stories about it, and you say, see, it's written in the press, so it must be true. This is exactly what they did with Trump.
Called the fake news the enemy of the people, and they are. They are the enemy of the people. Because they have no sources, they just make them up when there are none.
We live in a society now where it's just first. Who cares? Get it out there. We don't care who it hurts. We don't care who we destroy. We don't care if it's true. Just say it. Sell it.
The president of the United States is racist.
The president of the United States is a weak man.
He's a racist.
He's a punk. He's a dog. He's a pig.
He's a bully and he's a bitch.
He's unfit to be human.
Anything you practice, you'll get good at. Including BS.
We've got some breaking news. Actor and musician Jussie Smollett from the hit show Empire was attacked and beaten early this morning in Chicago.
Racism is alive and well.
And that says a lot about the place that we are in our country right now. The fact that we have these fear mongers, these people that are trying to separate us, and it's just not okay.